Hi guys, I'm currently in the sun so you can see my oily skin texture, but I'm here for it. And basically this video is gonna be a good one, a long one, and very close to my heart, and that's gonna be about birth control. So welcome back to the Acne Channel. It's your girl Liz, aka Pretty Progress 23. Now, I was on birth control for very, very long time, 5-6 years on and off. There was a couple of months where I took a break, but then I just hopped back on it because it was kind of like my remedy. I posted a reel the other day on my Instagram and I was posting about all the different side effects that birth control causes, and it went viral. It hit 7 million views and I was just like, wow, so many women could relate. So many people commented down in the section below talking about how, you know, they had blood clots, they had migraines, they had, you know, acne breakouts and all sorts of issues. And you can definitely check the comments. I've also had a lot of rude comments, many misinformed judgment from men, but that's another story and I want to get straight into why I want to do this video. So birth control. Now, when I was 16, I was put on birth control pills, hormonal birth control pills for my acne. It wasn't because of sexual activity, it was because he said, look, it looks like your pimples are, you know, very severe and I'm gonna prescribe you birth control pills. And the first one was, from memory, it was Yaz or Yasmin, one of those two. And then after 3 months, like, I felt like my boobs were going bigger. I was gaining a little bit of weight. My skin didn't get better at all. It just plateaued. It was just like nothing really got better or worse. And then when I came off it, that's when my body freaked the hell out. And so he was like, actually, I'll try another birth control method for you, Diane. And I was like, okay, let's try that. Cause I put my soul, my faith, my hope all into these general doctors who just kept on prescribing me medication. And I was young at this point, and I didn't really understand the side effects of birth control. And so I was on that, I was on Lovette, I was on a couple of others, and I got used to it. My periods were apparently regulated, but by the way guys, when you're in the pill, that's not your natural menstruation. It's actually hormonal withdrawal, so because your body doesn't have those synthetic hormones. Okay, so I realized that, so while my skin was kind of like on and off, breaking out here and there, I didn't understand why I was breaking out. Like, I was doing everything so well, I was eating healthy, but there were still underlying issues and I was not educated. And I think I am finally admitting how ignorant I was, and it's kind of sad because in today's society, women are not being educated about their bodies, about their vaginas, about their health enough, and male doctors just over-prescribe birth control pills, antibiotics, Roaccutane, without really understanding that this is just a band-aid solution and it's a mask. And I think people who are offended by that, I'm sorry, but I think you really need to dig deeper. Anyways, I worked with my naturopath and she's helping me transition off the pill. It's been 2 months now. And what happens is, so last month I was breaking out all over my left cheek. I was breaking out on my forehead on the side and a bit on this cheek. And I was freaking out because I didn't have cystic acne for a longest time. And once I came off the pill, I had two big ones right here. And my skin is also really oily and it's never as oily as this. A lot of women who get off the pill will undergo what is called post-birth control syndrome. Now this is all the different side effects that happens when your body is kind of weaning off those synthetic hormones. The first one is an androgen rebound. So when you're on the pill, your natural hormones, including testosterone, is suppressed. And once you're off it, all of this is going to be elevated and it's going to affect your oil glands, making you more prone to acne breakouts. And that's exactly what I experienced. I had pimples on my cheeks, all over my face, and it was just about to get worse. However, I've been supplementing, which I'll talk about later, or I'll put it for another video because this one might be a little bit long. So just be wary of how your hormones can be out of whack for a couple of months after stopping the pill. The next one is birth control also depletes your zinc. So zinc is really necessary for your immune system, and once that's compromised, then your body isn't going to be able to fight back those infections, including acne. Zinc is also necessary to help you use vitamin A, and vitamin A, a good amount of that allows you to have healthy skin. So the depletion of zinc will affect vitamin A, and it kind of works as a whole system. The next one is a huge one, and I speak about this all the time. Birth control pills can also affect your microbiome. So when your gut is compromised, that could lead to food sensitivities, further inflammation, irregular bowel movements, poor breath, acne breakouts, stress, brain fog. The number is endless, and I know it's scary, but it's the truth. I feel like a lot of people comment on my video, oh my god, fear mongering, this is like, you're instilling unnecessary fear and anxiety. And I'm like, we have the right to know what's going on in our bodies, because when I was 16, 17, up to 22, no doctors told me this. They just swept the side effects under the rug and said, don't worry, like, you know, don't worry about the blood clots, don't worry about this. And then I have on the other side, all these women commenting that they almost died because of birth control pills. And I think it's so important just to know the pros and cons. And once you have that information, then you can make the right decision for yourself. If you feel like birth control pill is the right option for you, or I'm all for it. Like I support you, but my personal preference is to make sure that my body is healing in a way that I'm actually supporting the root cause and healing myself in a way that it's actually long-term. It's kind of scary, like you don't know what your body's gonna be like after the pill. But anyways, back to the microbiome. There has also been a lot of scientific research that the birth control pills not only affect your gut, but it can also affect your vagina flora. So you could be more prone to UTIs, yeast infections, and my naturopath has also agreed with this, and it's exactly why I've been going back to her. She understands why things are happening in the women's reproductive system, and my doctors have not understood that, and they just kept on prescribing me antibiotics over antibiotics and more medication, and it was a vicious cycle. When I had BV, so bacteria vaginosis, he prescribed me antibiotics. After antibiotics, I had thrush, and I'm just like, that's not healing me. Okay, I think this video is turning into a rant. Okay, I'm sweating. Okay, anyways, so this is why I'm no longer on birth control pills, and I'm healing the way, the best way I can, and I feel like I feel a lot better. I haven't had BV and yeast for the last 2 months, which is a good sign. And yeah, let's go on to the next one. The next one is that it puts a lot of pressure on your liver because of the amount of synthetic hormones that your body is being fed. So when you get off hormonal birth control pills, your naturopath, your doctor, whoever, will often encourage you to take like a liver detox supplement. I've been taking P2, but I don't want to recommend you guys yet. I want you guys to go to a health professional. This is just an introductory video so you can better understand what's going on. So yeah, your liver might not be functioning at its best, so you need that extra support because your body was so used to years and years of synthetic hormones. And if your liver isn't working at its best, like it's one of the largest organs and it's helping you detox, and if you're not detoxing and cleansing properly, then again, your body is going to suffer from overgrowth of bacteria. It's going to be further inflamed, and you don't want that. Those are some of the main reasons why I stopped the hormonal birth control pill, and my skin has been doing a lot better because I've been supporting my gut health. That means I am making sure that I'm eating anti-inflammatory foods. I'm gonna upload a lot of recipes later, making sure that I'm taking liver support supplements as guided by a health professional, making sure that I'm consistent with my skincare, making sure that I have a lot of flax seeds to help my digestive system. Okay, if you don't have flax seeds, then think about other foods with a lot of fiber, because you want your digestive system to be working, and that way you're cleansing and detoxing from those hormones. And I also highly recommend to monitor your blood sugar levels. So when I talk about blood sugar, if you're somebody who starts to crave a lot of sugar on the shelf and you want to overindulge, you feel like you're stressed and you're sweating, those are the signs that your blood sugar is out of whack. If you have brain fog, make sure you're supporting your body with the right nutrients. Avoid refined sugar and cut out dairy. But when I say cut out these things, also add in these good nutrients so you're not overly focused on the restrictive dieting. And another way to balance your blood sugar is making sure that you have enough healthy fats and protein to optimize your gut, to optimize your body. And one big factor is stress. I'm de-stressing and managing as much as I can, taking deep breaths to kind of heal my body, and also have patience, because after stopping the birth control pills, you're going to be an emotional wreck. I was crying literally once every week, and I felt like I couldn't breathe, and my anxiety levels were like so high, and it was so foreign to me. I felt like I was struggling on my own, but know that there's a whole community out there. And yeah, so that's pretty much a quick video. I'm gonna try to like dissect it a little bit more and do proper in-depth videos on my Instagram and my YouTube. So I'll see you guys there. Good luck on your healing journey, and I hope you do more and more research, and this video just inspires you to further educate yourself on this topic matter. And I hope you guys have a lovely day, and big kisses. Mwah. Bye guys.